In this video, I teach you what a Temtem lair is, the rewards you get, and how to unlock it to obtain the new mythical Temtem, Tyranak. I'm Milars, and I've successfully completed the lair 6 out of the 6 times I attempted it. 3 of those runs were with random parties. The Sepanku updates went live earlier this week, just yesterday as I'm writing the script, so there will be many more videos covering the new Sepanku features. Subscribe and hit the bell icon if you don't want to miss them. Now let's get into it. First off, what is a lair? Lairs are Temtem's answer to Pokemon raids, but way better. They're basically a fun, roguelike minigame. Players form a party of 3 to 5 people, then get sent to traverse a randomly generated dungeon. Each player has their own path separate from the others, but some resources collected are shared collectively among all of the party members, so coordination helps a ton. Along the path of the dungeon, players collect rental Temtem, shop for medicine and gears, trade items, and battle to earn rewards. All of this preparation culminates in one big boss battle with the new mythical Temtem, Tyranak, where you will have to use the rental squad and the items you collect along the path to defeat this monster Temtem with 5 health bars. Yes, 5. Don't worry though, I will have a lair and a Tyranak boss fight strategy video coming up soon that I'll link in the iCard above and in the description below. To unlock the boss, parties have to collectively obtain at least 18 mythical jewels. Jewels and other resources are collected from various nodes. These nodes are Get Temtem, Karakuri, Shop, Rest, Chest, and Trade. Get Temtem is what you would expect it to be. You get Temtem. If the cloud only has one face, you get one Temtem. If it has two faces, you get two Temtem. These rental Temtem's levels seem to range from 80 to 100. They have random SVs and TVs. Each Temtem starts out with no set moves, so you have to arrange its moveset to your liking, though note that you can always change the moveset when not in a battle. Karakuri nodes are Temtem battles. An NPC will have a random team of Temtem also leveled 80 to 100. The more orbs on the top of the Karakuri, the harder the battle will be. Beating the Karakuri lets you pick one of 3 rewards. A random Temtem to add to your squad, a mythical jewel, or a random buff that affects your entire party of players. You also win some currency specific to the lairs called Sin Stars. The more orbs the Karakuri has, the more Sin Stars you will be rewarded. Sin Stars are shared between the entire party. You can spend Sin Stars at the next node we'll talk about, shops. At the shops, you can buy medicine to heal your Temtem both in and out of battle. You can also buy gears if you scroll all the way down. The gears in the shop are randomly selected each individual lair, though the pool of gear stays the same if you visit the shop multiple times in the same lair instance. You can only buy one of each gear. The pool of gear is not shared with other players, so buying a specific gear does not prevent other players from buying it. Remember, Sin Stars are shared by the entire party, items and gears are not. The Rest node revives and fully heals your party along with removing any status conditions they may have. The Chest node is a bit of a wild card. You can obtain anything from random Temtem, gears, medicine, party buffs, or mythical jewels. Chests with 2 locks have more rewards than chests with 1 lock. The last node is the Trade node. The game will ask you to trade your gear, Temtem, squad health, or jewels in exchange for buffs, jewels, Temtem, and or gear. You have the option to decline the trade. Do know that you can exit the game and log back in with no problems, though don't leave your party members hanging for too long. If you lose any battles against the Karakuri, you will have the option to trade in jewels to revive your entire squad and continue. For the first 9 nodules, the cost to revive is 2 jewels, and you can go into the negative. From the 10th nodule onwards, it cost 4 jewels to revive. I spent an hour systematically killing my own team every nodule just to figure out when the price increased. It was not fun. If you want me to continue doing stuff like that for videos, leave a like on this video to show me you appreciate it. If not, it's alright. I'll just reconsider spending so much time to find every bit of information. The jewel cost is almost never worth reviving, since if you use too many jewels, the entire party cannot continue to the boss fight and get rewards. Instead of reviving, exit the lair and try again. If your party has not collected enough jewels, you can exit the dungeon near the beginning of the lair. At the end of the path, there is a stand you can interact with to get to the boss Tyranak. You can only access the boss if your entire party has collectively collected 18 jewels. The boss is fire in nature and only uses 2 moves. Plague and Extinction. The only type it is weak to is Toxic. The boss Tyranak has 3 traits that are all active in battle. The first one is Frightening, which disables Temtem's gear for the first two turns of battle. The second one is Neutrality, which prevents Tyranek from gaining status conditions. There is currently a bug that allows Tyranek to doom itself, but that will be patched soon. The third ability is Toxin Crusher, which boosts Tyranek's damage to Toxic Temtem by 30%. The boss has 5 bars of health, aka 5 lives. Once you deplete all of the health from one bar, all actions will cease that turn and the boss will refill its HP if it has any lives left. Moves that were ordered but not executed won't use any stamina. Any stat boosts or decrease Tyranek had will be wiped when it refills its HP bar. The first time you successfully beat Tyranek that week, you'll be rewarded with a Tyranek egg with random SVs, a random trait, and no fertility. In beating the boss, you'll also garner other rewards such as Telomere Hacks, Egg Technique Courses also known as ETCs, Wishy Will Coins, Incubator Tickets, and DNA. The egg is a weekly reward, but the other rewards you can get no matter how many times you do it. This means that this is an easily farmable way to get Telomere Hacks and ETCs. You unlock this lair by bringing a Temtem of every type to these pedestals scattered in the Anak Volcano. Be prepared to fight tamers with level 70 Temtem blocking the pedestals. You can make multiple trips to and from the Temporium if you don't have high-level Temtem that also fulfill the pedestal's requirements. Two of the pedestals are also in the Fire Shrine, which you could only access by fighting the 4 Fire Cultists using your own team of Fire Temtem. A full party of Fire Koish, Volcranes, and or Drakashes makes short work of the Cultists. Finding every one of these pedestals can get confusing, and since they're all in different rooms, it's hard to show you where they are on the map, so I'll break them down to you into 3 categories and show you where they are in relationship to one another. Once you enter the Anak Volcano, there are 3 climbing sections that I'll label left, middle, and right. In the right section is the Toxic. And Neutral pedestal. In the middle section lies the Melee pedestal, as well as the Fire and Wind pedestals locked behind the Fire Shrine. In the left section is the Digital, Nature, Earth, Crystal, Electric, Mental, and Water pedestal. Once you've activated all of these pedestals, go to this room in the center of the big circular area. Interact with one of the 4 bulls to start or join a party to traverse the lair. You can find people to join you by either typing your number in chat, checking out the Looking for Group channel in the official Discord, or asking your friends to join. Alternatively, hit the join button in the menu party and type in someone's code to join someone else's party. If you want to activate all of the pedestals in one go, you'll have to defeat the Fire Cultists before so you can access the Wind and Fire pedestals. Then, you can use this team, as it has all 12 types. It's not the only team you can make, it's just the one I could make that could still be the Tamer's level 70 Temtem. That's all there is to the mechanics of lairs! If you found this video helpful, consider giving it a thumbs up, leaving a comment telling everyone if you got your Tyranek egg yet, and sharing this video with your friends. I also stream on Twitch, so feel free to drop a follow and come chat with us when we're live! I have a Temtem giveaway every Monday. Usually the stream starts around 11 PM EST, but I've been experimenting with starting the stream earlier at 8 PM instead. Join us and you might win a perfect Temtem or even a Luma! More Sepaku videos will be coming out soon, so if you want more guides and other Temtem content, subscribe and hit the bell icon, and I'll see you next time!